So let me introduce myself further than what your MC just told you. My name is Aiman Azlan. I'm a youth mentor. So I mentor the youth. Basically, I teach the youth, I mentor the youth, specifically about self-confidence. But today, we're going to talk a bit further than self-confidence. We're going to talk about your life.
Ooh.
Okay. Talk about your life, eh? Your life, okay? I want to talk about beyond your exams, beyond your scholarship, beyond your interview. I just want to talk something bigger, you know? I want to talk about your dream, your passion, what you like, what you are good at, the things that you aspire to become. That's the topic of today. You're already the best, but you don't know it yet. Okay? You are already the best, but you don't know it yet. And what's my proof? The proof that I have that you are the best is that you are here. I know, I don't mean here in MRSM though. I mean here on earth. You are here out of billions. You study biology, right?
Yeah.
Out of billions, you're the one that's chosen. So you're already the best. Already the best. But it's not enough to just be the best, meaning that you are alive. The next question will be, what will you do with the life that you're given? You're already alive. So congratulations lah kan? Tahniah. Woo, apa hidup? That's fine. That's fine. Great lah kan? Kita dah hidup. Which means that one thing, we already a winner. Tapi jangan stop di situ. Do not stop there. Ask yourself the next question. Okay, now I'm alive. Now what? Nak buat apa dengan kehidupan ni? Now you are what? 40 years old?
14.
Oh sorry, 14 eh? 14. So you are 14 years old. How many years left that you have in school? About 3 lah. About 3. Unless you go to form 6, you have 4 years. But generally you have 3 years to go, okay? 3 years, is it short, long? It's very short, right? It's very short one. I mean, you're 14 now. Do you know you have lived on earth for 14 years?
Yes.
Perasan tak? Ke macam, eh? I'm already 14. Right? Eh? Dah balik dah. Time flies so fast, right? Time flies so fast. So, the next 3 years, trust me when I say it, is going to go by so quickly. Laju sangat. I remember when I was in MRSM. Yes, I was MRSM student. The 2 years that I was in MRSM flew by so fast. I did not even realize. Oh, dah grad dah. And then after that, we had to think about university, what degree to take, what scholarship to take, which country to go to. You know, MRSM, fikir besar-besar kan? Mesti nak pergi luar je tak? Kan? Overseas. That's the kind of thinking that I want you to have. I want you to think big, you know. Not because you're MRSM student. I know MRSM student has their specialty, right? Special sikit. But just because you are a student, you should think big. Okay? So the first question I want to ask you is, where do you want to go? Okay? Now, this is a map of which country?
Asia.
I'm glad you know it. If not, tolong keluar negara ni, eh? Okay, where are we right now? Okay? Somewhere here. Okay, we are somewhere there. Now, I want to ask you, is Malaysia big or small?
Small.
Very small, right? But even in this tiny country that we live in, have you gone through all the states? Hey, one state left. Which state? Sarawak. And then you gone all 14 lah. Congrats lah. You dapat stiker tak? Tak dapat kan? Okay. So, how many states yang belum lagi you jelajah that you haven't gone to yet? 2, 1, 3. Anybody here never go outside of their state? Ada ke? Selama ni duduk kat Selangor je, ada? Tak ada eh? Tak ada eh? Okay, so you have gone through some travelling lah. But even Malaysia, that's so small, you haven't gone through everything, right? So can you say, I know Malaysia? Not yet, right? You cannot say, I know Malaysia if you haven't like travelled all over Malaysia. You can't say that. Because there are so many states in Malaysia, so many people you haven't met. So many cultures and subcultures that you haven't exposed yourself to. So you can't say, oh, I know Malaysia. Awak, aku duduk kat Perlis 50 tahun. Baru Perlis, no ha. By the way, this is where I came from. So I drove from Perlis to Selangor to meet you guys. Yeah. So you can't say I know Malaysia if you live in Perlis all your life. You know Perlis, but you don't know Malaysia. Itu bukan Malaysia. What about this map? Okay, quiz. Where is Malaysia? Sesat dah. Mana? Ni Rusia. Can you see how small we are? Nampak ni? Nampak tak? Tu kita tu. This is us. This is us. Malaysia. It's a small dot on a big map. So I want to ask you, fellow Malaysians, where do you want to go? Korea. Okay, sebab apa? Adakah sebab you nak pergi Korea nak belajar engineering? Atau nak jumpa Lee Kuang Soo? Okay, Korea, okay. Mana Korea? Ni Jepun? Ni Korea kan? Kan? Di sebelah kan? Betul tak? Okay. That's Korea. This is Japan. I've been to Korea, by the way. Very nice place. I wish you could go too. I went to the K-pop gallery. You know the actor Rain? Actor, singer Rain, right? Okay, so there's this one gallery, right? Sabar sana, saya nak cerita sah. There is one gallery of all the K-pop artists, the big ones lah. So they have like this small mini museum lah, lebih kurang. Ada all the pictures and everything. And this is one place where they put all the handprint of the artist. Baru handprint bukan tangan betul bro. Anyway, so I went to the handprints, look at the names. And because I'm not a K-pop fan, I know only one name lah, Rain. So I saw Rain, like, whoa, Rain! And this is two handprint that says Rain. So I'm like, try tengok. And I found out that my hand is exactly the same size as Rain. So siapa nak salam dengan Rain? Hampa tak boleh lah. Hampa tak boleh. Aku cakap kat depa ni. Anyway, other than Korea, where else do you want to go? Think big. Nak pergi mana? Rusia. UK. Ayat. Geografi aku fail sebenarnya. Kat mana UK? Somewhere on the map lah. Okay, but UK is a very big place. Where in UK? Manchester, Liverpool, Leeds, Bristol, Liverpool. Hang kata Liverpool sebab Amin nak bola, betul tak? Okay. Sekarang saya nak pergi ke sini pula. Saya pernah pergi Liverpool. Saya lalu lah Anfield Stadium tu. Lalu tak masuk pun pasal kena bayar. Kaya sangat ke apa? So lalulah Anfield Stadium masuk Liverpool. Saya baru tahu ni trivia, hampa tak apa, tidur sat. Liverpool English depa lain. They have a different English in Liverpool. Not dialect tau, like a different language. Like this lah kan, as if you go to Kelantan, they speak Malay but very different Malay, right? I know because I'm from Kelantan. Okay? Apa? Aku duduk kat Perlis tapi asal Kelantan. Asal? Okay, so like you go to Kelantan, right? They speak Malay but different Malay, right? So in Liverpool, they speak English but very different English. So different, they have a dictionary for Liverpool. So yeah, if you want to go to Liverpool, sure, but you have to learn a new language lah. Okay? Anyway, so this is how big the world is. So again, just like if you haven't traveled Malaysia, you can't say that you know Malaysia. If you haven't traveled the world, can you say you know the world?
No.
Can you say, I know everything that's out there?
No.
You cannot. So the first thing that I want to drill inside your mind is when you think big and dream big, include traveling in your dreams. I don't care what you want to do. You want to be a teacher, engineer, lawyer, accountant, even a garbage man. I don't care. Really, I don't care. Put traveling in one of your to-do list. Because with traveling, what will happen is that you get smarter with traveling. It's the best education you can have. But you have to travel with the mindset of a traveler lah. Jangan travel dengan mindset turis. Faham? Mindset turis macam ni tau. Dia pergi Korea, dia selfie balik. Tapi Korea, selfie dekat tangan rain tu, tu balik. But they don't learn anything. They just there to take a selfie, put on Instagram and then say, aku dah sampai, kau belum. That's a traveler, they travel and they see things, right? They learn things. They understand people. One of the things that I learned, okay, I'll share with you, from my traveling lah. I've been to UK, Canada, US, Turkey. I've been to, mana lagi? Korea, Singapore, Mekah, Madinah. Yeah, Mekah, Madinah. Alhamdulillah dah sampai. So, I've been to all these places. One thing that I realize that you probably don't know in school, because I did not know when I was in school, so I want to share with you today. One thing that I realized is that when it comes to English speaking, people don't really care about grammar.
Yeah.
Have you traveled before? You traveled to outside of Malaysia, right? People don't care about grammar. What they care about is, aku faham ke dok orang kata orang ni. Right? You go to United States, UK, like Liverpool I mentioned, they don't care about grammar. You can speak English with the most horrible grammar, but if they understand you, they become your friend. Anywhere in the world. Mekah, Madinah included. Right? So that's one thing that I learned. But here, we are so patriotic about English that a single grammar error is like a death sentence, you know. Oh, orang kata was sebenarnya is tau. Oi, let. I know the grammar is wrong. I know. And I have to learn, right? I have to learn proper grammar. But in real world, if you travel around, they don't really care. What they care about is the message. Right? They care about the message. I'll give you one example, eh? I remember this. I think I was 11 years old at this time. 11 or something. I was walking with my father in Kelantan at Pasar Siti Khadijah. Okay. So I walking with my father, and then we came about this one fruit stall. They sell fruits, you know, fruits. And on the stall there's like this guava fruit. Guava, jambu. Ke jambu air? Tak ingat dah. Guava lah lebih kurang. Jambu air. Eh? Guava je batu kan? Ha ha ha. So there was these two tourists, you know, Mak Saleh from outside, who wants to buy this fruit. And this Mak Saleh asked a very simple question. She asked, how much? Simple kan? How much? But you know, the lady at the back, you know, old Malay lady, dia tak berapa faham English sangat. Dia tahulah satu dua perkataan. So dia kata apa?
One.
Okay, so back and forth lah. A tourist macam, how much?
Like, one.
How much?
One.
Ulang alik, ulang alik. Saya dengan bapak saya macam ni. Nah, I was kidding. So my father went there to help the lady lah. And then the lady got the sale. So the point is, in the world, what people are more interested in is the message. Can I understand you or not? Even though the tourists speak perfect grammar, right? If you don't understand, there's nothing, no communication happen. So yeah, travel, eh? Travel the world. And this is my traveling story lah. Okay? Take it in. Serap dulu. Okay? Lihatlah. Okay, this is a little bit of my traveling story, okay? A little bit of my traveling story. And the point of this story is to tell you about dreams and passion and interest. Okay? Because that's the topic of today. And you will do your exercise later on the piece of paper that you have. Itulah. We will do it later, okay? 2006. You guys, umur berapa tahun time tu? Dah lahir ke belum? You are one? Ha! Serious? One eh? Wow! Okay. I feel so old now. 2006, I was form 4. Okay, buat calculation sekarang. Aiman Azlan berapa umur dia? I was form 4 in 2006 and I, Alhamdulillah, managed to go to MRSM Langkawi. Okay. Before you say anything, no, I was not with Nelofa. But Nelofa was my senior 1 year. So I was like in the same school as Nelofa lah. Speaking of Nelofa, there was just only one time that I met her lah. It was in the koperasi. She was about to photostat something and her paper got stuck. I was there and I was like, paper got stuck, and I helped her unjam the paper. So I helped her unjam the paper, and then that's it. That was the first and last time I met Nelofa. She doesn't even remember me, but I remember that moment. I will tell that story every time. Ya, dah orang famous kan, kita ambil kan? Tumpang sekali. So yeah, MRSM Langkawi 2006. I came from a very normal school, everyday school. Orang panggil go-go, government school. Kan? Go-go kan? I don't know, back in the day, they call us go-go or something. Government. Budak government. Dia ada istilah-istilah dia, betul tak? I came from a very normal school, not an elite school. I came to MRSM Langkawi. It was a very huge opportunity for me. And back then, I already dream big lah. Already dream big. I want to like go overseas. I want to be this. I want to be that. I want to become a scientist. Like, wow, yo. So 2006, I went in. I did my best. 2007, I got my SPM result. Straight A1. Woo! Okay. And then, straight A1, scholarship lah kan? Apa lagi? So, I apply for a few scholarship and I got JPA. Full scholarship, full everything. And that scholarship, based on the course that I chose, so I chose biotechnology as my course. Okay? Because again, I want to become a scientist, right? Adalah dia punya dream dia, want to become a scientist, this halal food researcher, blah, blah. So, JPA scholarship, biotechnology. So they send me to Canada. Ping! Why Canada? I have no idea. They just chose the country, I just went there. So Canada for 4 years, that's where I've been. And in Canada, there are so many experiences that changed my perspective, you know. Like for example, actually, Islam is everywhere. Islam is everywhere. Probably the non-Muslim cannot relate lah, but as a Muslim, you know, who've been in Malaysia all his life, whenever I want to go overseas to the Western world, I feel afraid, you know. Like, ish, makanan halal ada ke? Masjid ada? Weh, kalau aku datang dia ditarik janggutku. Right, we have this fear, Islamophobia and so on and so forth. But then when I was there, tak apa pun. Okay je. Right? People are friendly, people are nice, they're just normal people just like us. And that's one of the things that traveling gives you. Traveling gives you reality. If you look at the news or social media, it's not reality. It's edited reality, you know? Edited reality. Like your Instagram account. You don't show everything, right? About your life. You only show the good stuff. Right? That's the media. But when you travel, it's unedited. It's raw. You get to see everything. The good, the bad, the ugly, everything. So 4 years, I was experiencing that. And in my second year, something interesting happened, you know. Bukan girlfriend, sorry. Too lambat lagi. In my second year of university, I realized that biotechnology may not be for me. Right? Maybe some of you have that question, right? Am I making the right choice? Right? Is this the pathway for me? Right? Do I want to be an engineer? Do I want to be a lawyer? So, at the time, I had this dilemma. Alright? Should I just go with the flow or should I go with what speaks to me, my interests? So it was a huge dilemma, obviously, because, you know, expectations, parents, scholarship, right? But I decided, after discussing with my parents, after discussing with JPA, I decided to change course. Not easy, not everybody can do it. But I decided to change my course from biotechnology. I switched to to nothing. Takkanlah nothing good. Nah, degree kau nothing. I switched from biotechnology to psychology. Okay, because I had this interest in people, like you guys lah kan. I'm interested in you. Like all your faces have a story. All your faces. Have a story, right? Some of you are tired, I don't know why, but there's a story there, right? Even before I started, I saw somebody sleeping. I'm not gonna say who, you know who you are. But there's a story there, right? Every face has a story, and I'm interested to know that story. And that's why I took psychology, to understand my story, and to understand other people's story. Now, I know. It sounds nice because I like it. For some people, other people, they're like, ish, serabut kepala lah nak dengar masalah orang ni. Yes, I get asked. People ask me, Aiman, tak serabut ke selalu dengar masalah orang ni? Tak jadi gila ke? Kata, dok, jadi gila kalau tak minat. But I love my job. I love what I do. Right? I get questions in my inbox, in my DM, to the hundreds. And I still feel that I want to do this job every day. That is the kind of thinking that you need to have for you. Even though you're only 14. 3 years to go and then you're in university. Not that long. So you have to think, what do I want to do such that when I wake up the next morning, I still feel I want to do that thing again. Memang letih kerja ni, betul tak? Mana ada kerja yang tak letih? Tanya mak ayah, kerja ni letih tak? Mak aku kata, ya letih cik. Aku besarkan hang pun letih. All job are tiring. But there are two kinds of tired. Two kinds. One, I say tired menyampah. Two, tired satisfied. Tired puas hati. Pernah tak rasa tired puas hati? Kan? Full day, full of activities that you love to do, and then at the end of the day, when you want to go to sleep, you're like, ah, oh, puas. Letih kan? Tapi puas. Tak sabar nak tunggu esok. You can't wait for tomorrow. The same thing with your dream. You should have that kind of interest and passion and dream. And of course, bila you dream tu, you akan berfantasi lah sikit. Which is fine. It's fine. As long as you understand, you have to come back to reality, it's fine. Okay, jangan terbang lama sangat. Landing dulu, okay? Landing dulu. So that's a bit of my story lah. A short version of my story. And I want to pass the question to you. Because usually when I talk to people and I say, this is what I do for a living, I'm a speaker, I talk to people, I listen to people's problem, I like it, I love it, I teach people, I mentor people, they be like, ni sebab tak ada kerja lain eh?
Amboi!
There was this one time, you know, I met this uncle. And I tell the uncle, I work for myself. I'm a motivational speaker. And the uncle says, oh, okay, so you are unemployed lah kan? Dia kata, aku tak ada kerja. I just told you my job. He's like, oh, you are unemployed lah. Because for a lot of people, a job means 9 to 5 with a paycheck at the end of the month. Understand? 9 to 5 with a paycheck at the end of the month. Which is fine. That is one type of job. Betul? Maybe your parents have that job. Your brother have that job. Your sister have that job. Right? Your uncle have that job. Maybe. But what I have found through my traveling is that if you just look around you, a job is much more than that. Right? Right? I remember one time, I was your age, I think. I was about form 2. I was in the car on the way back from school. My mother saw the garbage man in our neighborhood. You know garbage man? Yang angkut sampah tu. Eh? So my mother saw the garbage man. And then my mother said to me something that I still remember to this day. She said, never underestimate the garbage man. I'm like, ha? At 14 years old kan? Ha? My mother said, never underestimate the garbage man. Jangan pandang rendah dekat orang yang angkut sampah tu. I'm like, okay. So she explained. Can you imagine what happened if the people who take our garbage every week decided not to take our garbage? What will happen? Busuk! Penyakit! Tak aman, kotor, right? And that's only one week. Sebab sampah kita berlambak dah seminggu tu. So don't underestimate any job basically. That's what my mother taught me when I was like form 2, just like you. So I understand that whatever job that you do, whatever thing that you want to do with the rest of your life, as long as it gives benefit to people, for me, I think in my point of view, you have succeed in life. Which comes to my next question. What is actually success? Okay? And I want you to write down because some people don't know what success means to them. Now, when you write down what the success means, don't tiru-tiru kawan. Don't look at your friends. Okay? I want you to write down what success means to you. Like imagine if you achieve that thing, you can safely say, I have succeed in life. So what is that thing? It's okay kalau jawapan you lain daripada kawan. It's okay. This is success for you. Does it have to be long? 2 minutes cukup kot? Eh? 2 minutes enough kan? What does success means to you? I'm not talking about what does your teacher say success is. I'm not talking about what does your parents say success is. I'm not talking about what your friends say success is. No, I'm talking about you. You, the individual you. What do you believe success is? And hopefully after you have written down your answer, I would like for like one or two volunteer to share with us their answer. Is that okay? Okay, right? And be proud of your definition because it's your definition. Nobody else's. Done? Who here has written down their definition of success? Awesome. Okay, just to keep the program going, can we just go to any volunteer who want to share their definition? Any volunteer? Yes, please. Come. Okay, tell me your name and what's your definition?
My name is Fikri.
Fikri?
Putri.
Putri. Okay, Putri, yeah. What's your definition?
And my definition of success is by doing what you've been interested with your whole life, by doing what others want for you, and that's good. So do what you want and go for it.
Okay. So doing whatever that you find interesting for you, doing what others want you to do, what others want you to do, and the last part?
No, do what you want to do.
Oh, do what you want to do, and then the second part? Oh, don't do what others want you to do. And the last part? You have three parts, right? And go for it. Yeah, yeah. Having courage to actually do it. That's a good definition. Meaning, if you can wake up every day to do the things that you find interesting and beneficial for other people, that's success, right? Whatever that thing is, you know. Whatever that thing is, it's interesting for you, it's beneficial for other people, success. Go for it. Even though people say, ish gaji tak banyak ah. Ish tak nanti orang kata apa pula lagi. Ih raya nanti malu eh. Even though people say that, you just go for it because it's your life, right? Good. One more volunteer. Any guys? Any guys first? No? You want? You hesitated? You nak ke tak nak ni? Okay. Okay, come. Your name and what's your definition?
My name is Muaz.
Muaz, yes.
My definition is to achieve what you want it to achieve,
uh-huh.
And also do what you want to do but with happiness.
Okay, to achieve what you want to achieve and to do what you want to do with happiness. That's a good definition. Now, whatever that you put inside your paper, whatever that you put on your paper, I want you to understand, this is mine on the paper too. I want you to take ownership, you know ownership, right? Own that definition. Now, your definition can change over time, understand? It can change over time because you're only 14, there are so many things in life that you have to discover, right? Right? And trust me, your definition will change, and that's okay. That's okay. As long as it's your definition. Understand? Maybe in the future you learn something new and then you decided, huh, I want to update my definition. It's okay. You can update your definition however many times you want as long as it's your definition. Why do I keep repeating your definition, your definition, your definition? Menyampang tu ya? Yeah, because you don't want to live your life based on what people say. It's your life, right?
Yes.
Whose life is it?
Mine.
It's your life. Now, I'm not asking you to become a rebellious child. No, not rebel, no. Wisdom, be wise. You are responsible for your life, understand? You are responsible for your life. So whatever that you do with your life, you are responsible for it. Good or bad? Kalau buat benda bagus, good, you are responsible, you get the reward. If you do a bad thing, you are also responsible, you get the punishment. Both ways, understand? Whatever it is, you are responsible, it's your life. So that's success. Now, let me just break it down. This is one recent story that happened. Who knows this story? Oh, you don't know this story, eh? Okay, one of you know this story. Okay, two of you know this story. Okay, this guy, he's only 16. Okay, he's only 16 years old. He's in the United States. He just won the first Fortnite World Cup. He won $3 million. Just himself. Seorang dia dapat 3 juta dolar. Darab 4, jadilah ringgit. Okay? Now, why am I showing you this? I'm showing you this because I want you to challenge the usual definition of success. What's the usual definition of success? Money, status, fame. Money, status, fame. Betul? Just Just remember the last time your Hari Raya or Deepavali or whatever celebration that you do where family gather. Remember the last gathering? When the parents talk about their children, they talk about their achievements as well, right? Oh, my son, he's an engineer. My son is a lawyer. My daughter is a... Hey, engineer jugalah, why not, right? My daughter, she's an engineer, right? And they somehow have this proudness, like, he's an engineer. Engineer. They naik sikit kat lah tu, engineer. But what if your daughter is a teacher? Oh, my daughter, she's a teacher. Tang hujung tu selalu, he's a teacher. Now, I'm not saying that to bash people. I'm saying that because it's something that we have educated ourselves without realizing it. Kita sudah mendidik diri kita dengan definisi itu sekian lama. Kita tak sedar. And that's why the lesson that my mother gave me when I was like 14, just like you, do not underestimate the garbage man, is a very valuable lesson. No job, if it is beneficial, halal, it's not illegal, no job is dishonorable, you know. So I have this weird dream in my head. If my son became a garbage man, I want to promote him to the world. I have this weird dream. Like, I have two sons. If my son became a garbage man, I want to promote him to the world. I want to show how proud I am that he every week collect garbage for other people. I want people to understand. Be proud of whatever that people do as long as it's beneficial and as long as it's what they want to do. Right? Now, for this guy, I'm not saying that he's not successful. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying, if this is the only criteria for success, is it worth it? That's my question. Because you go to the next family gathering, if somebody says, my gaji every month is 12,000 ringgit, they're like, whoa! Or they go outside and look at the car, the type of car that they drive. Oh, Vios. Oh, X70. Oh, kancil. People look at these things, status, money and fame. Status, money and fame. But is that success? That's what I want to drill inside your head. Is that success? Question mark. Is that your success? Is that how you define success? So you get money, fame, and then you get status. That's it? You're successful? Maybe. Maybe not. Depends on your definition. Are you happy having all those things, right? Your definition, right? Are you happy having all those things? So many rich and famous and high status people, they're not happy, right? But so many poor, like, people outside the society, people you don't even, like, consider, they're so happy. I'll tell you one story, eh? Again, in Canada, 4 years, right? So Canada has these four seasons. They have winter, autumn, fall, and summer, right? Okay. And Canada, the place that I lived in Toronto, is a city life. And you have homeless people on the streets. Now, homeless people on the streets, you know, there are variations of personality lah. Ada yang macam mereng sikit. Just biasalah kita jumpa kan. But there are homeless people who are very nice. Very kind. Very, 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 very cheerful. He looks happy. And I remember one guy, he lived near my apartment, you know. He always there. Sometimes lah, not every week. He always have this smile on his face. Homeless guy. Smile on his face. And whenever I give like a bread or like money, he's like, oh, thank you, brother. Thank you. Like smiling. So what is success? Because when you see that in the world, you question, you know, is dia nampak happy je? Now, I'm not saying everybody become homeless, eh? I'm not saying that. I'm just saying this idea of success, we have to investigate and reinvestigate what it means. Even if you are just form 2. I don't agree when people say, oh, dia orang ni form 2 je, budak-budak lagi. No. Eh, you budak-budak lagi je? Do you believe that? You bukan budak-budak lagi. You budak-budak besar. Okay? Besar dah. Alright? Now, this is the triangle of success. Just to put it simple, okay? Based on what we discuss. And then we go to the to the apa nama tu, to the worksheet. All right, this is a triangle of success that I call it. The first thing in the triangle is purpose. Okay, you need to have a reason. And I know that before I came here, I asked your teacher to ask you if you have any questions for me. And one of the questions that you guys ask is motivation. I don't have motivation. Betul? Some of you have that question. I know, because your teacher asked me to. I asked your teacher to ask you. Some of you have issues with motivation. You don't have motivation to continue. Maybe you want to quit. I don't know. And you ask how to be motivated. Well, the answer, number one, is what's your purpose? Innamal a'malu binniyat. Everything starts with a purpose. Everything starts with your intention. If your intention is strong, right, meaningful, then whatever happens in your life, you will not lose that motivation. Of course, motivation can go down, but it can easily go back up again because you understand this is my purpose. When, let's say, for example, you get a B in your exam, you're like, Astaghfirullah! Like, oh, B, oh my God, ah! You get sad. You lose motivation, but not for long because you understand, oh, my purpose is to become the best I can be. It's okay. B today, A tomorrow. Ha, naik balik. But if either you don't have a purpose or you have a purpose but it is not strong enough, then when challenge hits, you cannot survive. When challenge hits, you'll be easily shaken. When challenge hits, you want to give up now because your intention is not strong enough. So again, write down, what's your main purpose? What's your main intention? The big why. And then ask yourself, is this strong enough? Is this meaningful enough for me? If the answer is yes, then, you know, continue lah. Keep on going. You are good to go. But if you say to yourself, ish, niat ni macam tak cukup kuat lah. This intention is not good enough. This intention is not strong enough. Then you have to change. Again, you are responsible, right? You can change. Change your intention. Maybe before this, your intention is I want to get straight A. That's my purpose. Straight A, straight A, straight A, straight A. That's my purpose. But then you realize something, right? In life, you can't get straight A all the time. Isn't that true? I'll give you one story, okay? Back when I was in MRSM, there was this one senior guy. Genius guy, you know. 4 flat every semester. 4 flat every semester. You have CGPA here in MRSM KKB, right? So 4 flat every semester, this guy. Excellent student. Every semester, 4 flat. Dekat senarai nama student yang cemerlang tu, tak payah tengoklah nombor satu siapa. Dah tahu dah, dia lagi. Tak. Everybody in that school sort of make a definite conclusion that this guy will be straight A until SPM. Okay? Guess what happened after SPM? He got 1B. To everyone's surprise. I don't know what happened, but you know, it happens. So if your main purpose is to just get straight A all the time, what happens when B comes? Because B will come. Like I told you, I'm a straight A student SPM, right? But not all the time. I get B, I get C, I get D. Yeah, D. Yeah, aku pernah dapat D. So you can't get A all the time. So if that's your purpose, then whenever B, C, D comes, you can't go on. So reinvestigate your purpose. Is that good enough? Is that good enough? Is that strong enough? Your decision, your choice, right? Second thing is power. Power here refers to your skill. Everybody has the superpower sendiri, betul tak? Siapa tengok Marvel atau DC? DC tak payah lah, DC tak best. Marvel. Ada DC fan here? I'm sorry lah, Batman fan eh, sorry eh. But Marvel, alright? Marvel much better. Okay, in the Marvel superhero universe, they're all superheroes, right?
Yes.
Right? But do they all have the same superpower?
No.
No. No, right? But just because you don't have a superpower, you have another superpower, does that mean that you should be sad? Like, for example, does Iron Man become sad that he doesn't have a hammer like Thor? No! Iron Man is Iron Man. He has his own thing. Thor is Thor. He has his own thing. So just like that, you in front of me right now, you have your own superpower, and I'm not joking. I'm not exaggerating. You do. And your superpower may be different from your friend. And that's okay. I'll give you one practical example. Who here... Okay, jujur eh? Boleh jujur tak? Selama ni dah jujur kan? Boleh jujur tak? Boleh tak? Boleh eh? Honest eh? Okay eh? Okay? Safe space, okay? I will protect you. Don't worry. Honest answer. Who here believe that he or she is not the academic type? Yeah. Not the academic type. Meaning, I cannot do mathematics, I cannot do science, I cannot do... And let me add. You already tried. You tried your best. But still you cannot. Raise your hands. Okay. Quite a lot of you actually. So like, not a mathematics person, not a science person, right? Okay. Does that mean you're a failure?
No.
No. It simply means that's not your power. That's it. That's all it means. My question is, if that's not your power, what is your power? Write down. I want you to write down. Okay? Do not focus on what power don't I have. Focus on what power do I have. If I'm not good at math, science, it's okay. I mean, you still need to study lah. You still need to study. What I'm saying is that in your future, maybe that's not for you. Maybe math is not for you. And it's okay. I'll tell you what's not for me. Athletics not for me. Believe me, I tried becoming a footballer. I tried. I went to the tryouts. You know the tryouts? Where they selected like the, you know, the young people who can play football. I actually went to one of the tryouts. Fail. So athletics is not my superpower. It's somebody else's superpower. So I don't worry about that. I focus on what's my superpower. My superpower is communication. I love doing that. English, my superpower. Science, my superpower. People, my superpower. May not be your superpower, but that's mine. It's okay. There's so many things that I cannot do. But you can do. So focus on that. What can you do? What's your power? Somebody here can draw. That's your power. I cannot draw. Orang lidi pun hodoh. Right? Have you got your superpower down? Yeah? Okay, two volunteer. Who wants to share their superpower? Hey, be proud tau. Be proud of your superpower. I mean, you nampak ke Thor macam, aku ada tukui? No, Thor was like proud. Yeah, this is my Mjolnir. So be proud of your superpower, because that's what you will use for the rest of your life. So siapa nak volunteer share your superpower? Alah, segar-segar betul lah you guys ni. I know why you're afraid. Again, I was MRSM student, remember?
Yes.
Okay. Let me tell you my story. Personal sikit, tak apa ke? Okay. Okay. Maybe your teacher doesn't know this, and it's good that they hear this from somebody in MRSM, in the system and in the school. Okay? Awak tengok belakang, nanti masuk dalam kamera. Kantoi ya, abis ya. Okay. My story eh. I know why you're afraid. MRSM, actually boarding school, sekolah asrama, is a very close community, betul tak? You guys know each other, betul?
Yes.
And I understand you're afraid to stand out because you don't want to be judged. I know the feeling. You know why I know? Because I was the one who stand out. In MRSM, I was the one who stand out. Voluntarily, I stand out. And people say a lot of things to me in MRSM. And you just imagine, you're a very close community, right? When people say something, you hear it. You hear it, right? And you can't run away. MRSM is not that big. So I know the feeling. But this is what I hold on to. And I want to pass this on to you, okay? This is what my father, before when my mother, again. This is what my father told me before I went to MRSM Langkawi. My father told me, he said, Aiman, this opportunity doesn't come all the time. So I want you to grab every opportunity that you can and excel. My father's advice. So the moment I entered MRSM Langkawi 2006, I was Form 4, I was determined. Every opportunity that I have, I grab. Right? Ketua kelas. Siapa lagi? Ni lah. Choral speaking. Cadet polis. Kelab kembara, naik Gunung Kinabalu. But when you become that person, you have a label on your head, betul tak? Orang yang selalu muncul. Kan? Back then, they call me capap. Oh, you tahu eh? You tahu eh? You tahu kan? I mean, apa lagi? Skema. Poyo. Apa lagi? Oh, yang ni best, yang ni best. I remember, this is one time, a senior. Okay, let me give you the context first. There was this one dataran that we call Dataran Hijau. It's the place where we do roll call and so on, right? So it's a place in between the two asrama, lelaki perempuan, right? In between. So we do a lot of like activities there, right? And there's a stage like this at Dataran Hijau. And there was this one time we had this activity where we would play music and somebody will do dedication. Right, saya nak dedikasikan muzik ini kepada dia. Okay, and they pay like 50 cent or whatever lah for that music dedication. Right, it was something that we want to do as an activity. So on the stage there was a table, laptop, and then the music. I was the DJ. Right, so my job is like to play music and then somebody wants to do dedication, pay to me and then I'll play the music and everything and I would announce it. Lagu ini didedikasikan kepada daripada I was holding the mic and everything. I was in my zone, right? Because this is what I love to do. And then one senior come and he shouted, "Gila mic!" Gila mic. He shouted. It was a very public place, you know. He shouted. So what's the point? The point is this. If you live your life trying to avoid people's judgment, sorry, you cannot. So you have a choice. Okay? You want to stand by what you believe or just follow what people say? It's a choice. I made my choice and Alhamdulillah, I'm proud of my choice. It led me here. Now you, in your close community, I know you have issues. I know you have your own label. Yang berterbangan. I mean, label is like so normal in MRSM, right? Every one of you have a nickname, betul?
Yeah.
Right? My nickname was Mr. Press. Because I was always the president. So they call me Mr. Press. I took it as a compliment, as something that I'm proud of. Mr. Press. Like, okay. Mr. Press. So, when I ask you, what's your superpower? I know that you don't want to tell people because then people will judge you. People will condemn you. I know that. But it's a choice. You want to just continue living that way or you want to be above them and stand out. I don't want to say either or. You choose what you want to choose, basically. All right. I'll ask again. Who here wants to volunteer to share their superpower? One. Ketana. Okay. Pasal you angkat and turun balik. If you change your mind, I respect that, so I don't want to force you, okay? What's your superpower? What's your name and your superpower? Nampak tak? Nampak? Judgment dah sampai kan? Dah dapat dah judgment tu. It's normal, biasa, biasa.
Irene.
Irene.
Uh-huh. Okay, so basically from my own perspective, I feel like my power is to be able to think the way that I want to. It feels like I always think about the universe and me, I try to find something new in everything. So basically I feel like I have questions and I try to find the answers. If I can't find the answer, I will try and not find it. So basically
okay.
That's how I think. Almost all the time, so...
You are curious and inquisitive. That's the
yes.
word. Yeah.
And basically, I'm a very physics person.
Physics oriented, eh?
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. Alright. So, any guys who wants to volunteer, share with us your superpower? Oh, napa, napa, napa. Okay, okay, okay. I want you to observe what happened right now. Okay? Usually, when somebody asks, siapa nak volunteer, you akan... Tolak orang lain. Muaz, Nabil, Aiman. Okay. Kan? Okay, okay, okay. No, 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 no. No, this is good. This is good. This is a life lesson. This is a life lesson, okay? This is good. I want you to observe what happened. This happened everywhere, you know. I've been doing this for 8 years. It happens everywhere. Whenever I say any question, ni dia ada soalan ni. Who wants to volunteer?
Ni volunteer ha.
They always push other people. Okay? Now, this is the lesson. This is the lesson. The person you push is the person who will succeed. So why don't you push yourself? Betul tak? I mean, it's okay lah kalau you macam baik hati sangat. Ah, hang lah pi, tak apa. Aku tinggal kat belakang ni. Hang pi lah. It's fine, it's okay. You have a generous heart. But remember this. The person you push will succeed. Either you push somebody else or you push yourself. Decide. You want to push somebody else? Fine, they succeed. People push me all the time. Right? Calling me gila mic, calling me capap. That's a push. They push me forward. It's fine, you stay back. There was this one time, they had this award, you know. I don't know, is in MRSM KKB ada award. Ada award night lah? Award night ada? Oh, tak ada? Okay, jangan buat. Okay? Saya cakap awal, jangan buat. Okay, saya bukan nak bagi idea baru. But, in my time, we had this award night where we would nominate amongst ourselves and give like award based on like names. Like for example, yang paling lawa. Benda-benda macam tu lah. Yang paling bersukan apa adalah nama-nama dia tu kita reka sendiri. And there was this one category. One bukan capak, nama dia lagi best. Kategori dia tak ada orang lain ke. Seriously. And I was nominated. Just bayangkan waktu award tu kan. Tak ada orang lain ke award. Calon-calonnya adalah dong daripada nama aku datang kat situ. Aku cakap, ya Allah. It hurts. But alhamdulillah, I did not win. Somebody else won that one. But, you know, that's the thing, okay? I just want to comment on that reaction, you know. When somebody asks for volunteer, you push somebody else. It's fine, but remember, whoever you push, they will succeed. So why not push yourself? That's the question. Why not push yourself? Why push other people? Okay. Anybody want to share their superpower? Yeah, bro. Okay. Start. Your name and your superpower. Yeah. Nampak. Judgment dah datang. Judgment dah datang dah, nampak? Biasa, normal. Yeah.
Okay, my name is Daudin.
Daudin.
Yes.
Daudi. Okay.
Okay. Okay. And my superpowers are I'm good at gaming and English.
Good. Game. What? Which game?
Like Dota, PUBG, something like that. Like
Fortnite, tak main Fortnite?
No.
PUBG, Dota.
PUBG, Dota. but like strategize. I'm good at strategizing things and carrying my teammates around.
Good, okay. So that's your superpower. Thank you for Daudi, yeah. Daudi. Okay. That's good, that's good. Okay, so far we have covered. Okay, let's recap supaya kita on track. Kita dah cover apa itu kejayaan. What is success? You have your own definition. Good. Next, we cover about purpose. This is where your motivation comes from. Your motivation doesn't come from a motivational speaker. No, you cannot rely on somebody like me, a motivator, to come to your school every time to give you motivation. It will not be long term. Trust me, it will not be long term. Our job is to just trigger. Tahu? Kerja kami trigger aje. Macam tweet saja. But to maintain the motivation, that's your job. And if you want to maintain your motivation, you go back to your purpose. Why do you do that? Why do you keep on doing it? That's your fuel. Otherwise, you run out and you stop and quit. The next thing we talk about is your power. Not everybody has the same power. It's fine. Like a lot of you says you're not math person, you're not science person, but still study, eh? Jangan lupa, eh? Still study. But I'm just saying, maybe that's not for you, and that's okay. That's fine. Right? Coming back to the garbage man example. Understand? And last thing is people. This is how all the things come together. You have your purpose, you have your power, and just like in the Marvel movies, you need somebody to save. Bayangkan Marvel movie tu tak ada orang yang nak diselamatkan. Boring yo. Just Thor tunjuk power dia je. Movie tu boring. Movie tu interesting sebab ada konflik, betul? Movie tu interesting sebab ada orang yang dalam bahaya. Like, ada orang jahat. Orang baik lawan orang jahat. Ada konflik. Maybe orang baik kalah sekejap. Lepas tu lalah kali menang. Itu yang buat movie tu interesting. In life, it's the same. Out there are so many problems. Betul? Right? Problems are macam ibarat orang jahat yang you kena tewaskan. Problems. Right? In the world, there are so many problems. And there are so many people with problems. So your job, as somebody with a purpose, as somebody with a kind of superpower, your job is to find a problem you can solve. Find a problem you can solve with your purpose and power. Can you solve everything?
No.
No, just find some that you can solve. If you cannot solve that problem, find another problem you can solve. The garbage man example. Oh, I love the garbage man example, really. Garbage man. Their purpose is to make sure that the environment is clean, make sure that people are comfortable living in their homes, right? Let's say that's their purpose. Their power is the ability to pick up the garbage every week. It's too power, siot. Sanggup buat kerja tu? Sanggup buat kerja tu? And sometimes they come in the afternoon, right? When they are very hot, right? And they come during that time to pick up your garbage. And some of your garbage are so disgusting, you know. Some of our garbage are like berair lah, betul ada dengan ulat-ulat lagi. But they are the ones who pick them up. That's power, superpower. And what problem of the people that they solve? The environment, our environment, our home become safer, cleaner. Because they do their job. So, a garbage man is actually successful based on this triangle. Understand? Notice that I don't mention status, money or fame. I don't mention the three things. Yeah, garbage men, they don't make a lot of money, right? They don't make a lot of money. They don't. But are they successful? That's a big question, right?